said, you know, I sound great, but I'm not a real people person, and I, you know, I'm not one of those people that likes to engage a lot. That's okay.
Thank you.
If you want to be here and not engage with our stuff, but take care of yourself by enjoying a nice sunny day and being on a lounger out here for a while, it's all good, okay? A spa-like day. We offer an opportunity, a buffet of things for you, and we hope you get involved, but the goal is to take care of yourself, all right? So, let me see here. I have notes here. Take a big breath. That's probably for me, but let's all take a big breath. Slowly let it out. One more. Slowly let it out. Isn't that an amazing tool that we forget about? I forget about. I'm in classes, I learn about this stuff all the time, and it's fabulous, and 5 minutes later, I forget it. You know, you understand that? You know, we get engaged, we learn a lesson or a tool, oh, this is so helpful, and a minute later, it's gone and we forget. So, it's okay, we keep reminding ourselves. A cancer survivor, by the way, I talked to a lady yesterday. She was down in physical therapy with Kim. Kim, are you out here?
Yep.
Where, Kim Postenbach. Where's Kim?
She's at her table.
Okay. Hey, Carol, would you get everybody out here, please? We're looking for Kim Postenbach. Thank you. Okay. Now I'll be a nice guy again. You see, I work for St. Joe's, and at times we're paid to be nice, and then at times in our offices and committee meetings we're really mean. Okay? I'm teasing. However, I talked to a lady yesterday and I said, are you a cancer survivor? And she didn't know how to answer that question. So I reminded her there is a definition that is sort of, it's from the National Coalition of Cancer Survivorship. And it says, from the moment of diagnosis, how many people here can remember that moment? That moment. I would think that that's blazoned in you and what happened. Just curious. I read journals and articles and this and that. I talk to people. How many people after that moment, and I'm assuming you heard from a physician or healthcare professional who then had some other things to tell you, how many people for the next 5 minutes don't remember a thing they said? Yeah, that's real stuff. And real people here. And, you know, as we have fun, and, you know, we all have our stories, you all have your stories. I am not a cancer survivor, knock on wood. I refuse to get an MRI because they'll probably find something, right? But even the lady today I talked to who's had a couple of cancers and recurrences and this and that, and maybe that is for a lot of you. Today's about having a good time, okay? Yeah. So the definition is from the moment of diagnosis and for the remainder of your life, you are a cancer survivor. How many people here are in treatment? You are cancer survivors. It's not out there in the future. It's not, there's some myths out there that, well, if you go 5 years, then you're cancer free. We know that's not even true. Right? However, it's nice to have that goal. Or there's people that say, I'm not a survivor yet because I'm still in treatment. The definition, from the moment of diagnosis and for the remainder of your life, you are a cancer survivor, okay? Hey, ladies back there, why don't you come up and join us? We'd love to have you. Be under the tent. Come on. Be a part of what's going on. These are all, I believe, a manicure. These people are going to be providing manicure. Yeah, give them a hand. Woo! Yeah, isn't that great? Thank you for being here. All the manicures are volunteers, volunteering their time today. And all the massage therapists are volunteering their time today. Yeah. Along with other people you see standing around who think that they're different and don't want to be a part of us. They are all volunteers. We have professionals. I mentioned Kim Postenbach. Raise your hand, Kim. Kim is a physical therapist, lymphedema specialist, works for our cancer exercise program. She's the one who was with a lady who called me yesterday, who may or may not be here today, but was un- sure how to answer the question about being a survivor. So that's why I brought that up, okay? Take care of you. Photography, this is Haida. Haida Stover is a cancer survivor! And she will be taking pictures of the day that we'll post on our St. Joe's Facebook page and various things. There was a sign up by registration, not sure anybody ever read it. If you do not want your picture taken, it's possible it may show up in the hospital magazine, it's just possible it may show up somewhere. It would probably not identify you by name because we probably might not know your name, okay? If there's anyone that says, I absolutely don't want my picture taken, please talk to Haida, okay? It's gonna be your responsibility. Talk to Haida. And it's okay, it's all cool. Are we clear with that one?
Yes.
Wonderful. And if you have little friends, you want a group shot or something like that, go for it, okay? And then we'll get things posted somehow and get back to you if we have your email address. Cecilia Moran, are you here?
I'm here.
Would you come over here, please? And all you people over here, what are you doing over there? Enjoying the sun. Those are more manicure students, etc. Okay? Woo! Cecilia Moran. For the last few years, we've had someone named Rita Vasquez come and help facilitate the Spanish-speaking support group. Rita can't be here today. She's taking a job with Hospice of San Joaquin, and she has a program today. Cecilia Moran is sitting in for Rita. The Spanish-speaking support group meets at 9:15, and she will help with that. Okay? We'll talk about schedule in a minute. Cecilia, thanks for being here. She's a medical center volunteer. Stay with us here. She's a principal, a retired school principal. So thank you, Cecilia. Okay, we're running out of time here. We're gonna sing that song, okay? Let's start with the chorus. What's that? What's the words again? That's like when you see the neurologist, right? He'll say, I want you to remember an orange, this and a that. Then he talks to you, he says, what are you supposed to remember? You go, what the hell? Okay? Today is a real treat. Look, we plant. Today is a real treat. Look at all the friends we get to meet. Hooray for today. Hooray. Hooray, okay. Jeff, can you get this microphone? Can you help me for a second?
Or maybe I can do it all by myself. Not be a big boy.
By the way, this is Jeff. Jeff comes every year. He sets up all these speakers, does all the sound stuff for us. He makes sure we have sound in the massage room, and he's just a cool guy. So I've known him for years. Did anybody here ever hear of or know of the Surviving Beautifully fashion show? A few people. This is our 10th annual treatment day. For 20 years before this, we did a fashion show called Surviving Beautifully. Life is not a dress rehearsal, featuring cancer survivors modeling positive attitudes about living. It was a fashion show format, and you would walk and we'd tell your story about who you are, not about your cancer. Very cool. That was 20 years, and he did the music probably for 20 years. Okay, here we go. Today is a real treat. Look at all the friends I get to meet. Hooray for today. Hooray. Okay, we'll get it right. Today is a treat meant for you. We planned lots of stuff for you to do. Self-care is number one, so pick wisely and have some fun. Here we go. Today is a real treat. Look at all the friends I get to meet. Hooray for today. Hooray. I can work on my body, take care of me, my health, natural oils, and do as I please. It's okay if my mind's in a fog, of course, a manicure, and maybe a massage. Today is a real treat. Look at all the friends I get to meet. Hooray for today. Hooray. Very good. One-to-one with professionals here for us all. They'll be lined up against the hotel wall. Meditation, gratitude, and classes galore. Enjoyed with new friends, who could ask for more? Today is a real treat. Look at all the friends I get to meet. Hooray for today. Hooray. And Reiki energy to help you relax. You got a question? Don't be afraid to ask. All the staff here today are volunteers. We're all here as one, through laughter and tears. Today is a real treat. Look at all the friends I get to meet. Hooray for today. Hooray!
Yo! Yo, mama!
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we have a tradition here for years, and that's the scarves. So if there's a scarf on your chair, would you please wrap yourself with it if you haven't already, okay? Take it out of your bag if it's in your bag. I'm going to tell you a story. Many, many years ago, time to listen, many years ago, a lady approached me and wanted to help her daughter who had stage 4 breast cancer in Texas. She developed a group, and to kind of honor her daughter, they got together and made scarves for this event. And that was her way of doing something. It filled her soul. After a long time, that group, for a lot of reasons, stopped meeting. Today, we have a lady who has cancer. She was here at this event last year. She's not here this year. She chose not to come. But she heard me talk about that group not making scarves. So her daughter said, Mom, I can help. Can I make scarves for the event? So Laura Laura's daughter, made a lot of these scarves. Yeah. But then there's also a lady, and her name escapes me this moment. It will come to me. Trish, who's the lady that picked up scarves in Lodi? Jean Pack. Now, my wife also has chemo brain. She's a 16, 17-year cancer survivor. Thank you for being here, Trish. Jean Pack, whose husband has cancer, made a lot of scarves just for today. They don't ask us to pay for the yarn to do anything. They just do it out of their heart and out of their love. So what we'd like to do is just say, let's take a moment. Just know that that scarf was made with intention. Maybe there was an intention for you to sit where you sat, and that scarf was actually made just for you for today. Okay. So let's just take a moment, listen to this song, and wrap ourselves in love.
Music is powerful. A lot of emotion here, from tears of different kind of tears and laughter and everything in between for this moment. Program is talked to and marketed to literally hundreds and hundreds of cancer survivors. And you chose to be a part of this special day. So you are very special in saying yes. For some of you, it's taking a risk. It's being out of your comfort zone, not knowing if you can trust what's going to happen today. And I'll add, I'm sure you've been in a position not knowing if you can trust the phlebotomist, the chemotherapy nurse, the person at radiation. Are they reading my scans correctly? And all those kinds of things, having to trust others. And today, you're kind of trusting us. And we are wrapping you with love in this event. You've got the scarves and everybody here. And as I say that, I mean everybody here. I mean you. You are a gift to somebody else also. So in my own way, I'm going to say it's not about filling your orange bag with stuff, okay? It's about filling your heart and your soul and your mind. Please, all of you, think of yourselves. That's why I brought staff under the tent. We are one here. It's amazing how much a smile can do for somebody else. This is true. Last week at work, somebody said to me, "Boy, I really like the way your tie and blah, blah, blah look," right? I thought, what are they? And then I looked at myself. It felt good. Wow, I was acknowledged. Such a simple thing, and it made a difference for me in that moment. So let's remember that. Let's make a difference to each other today, okay? I'm going to say this nicely. Please hear this as intended. It's not all about you. Okay, someone said amen. You get that, right? It's not all about you, okay? It's a we here. We are a community. We are blessed in so many ways. Just the mere fact that we can be here, that we've got the clothes and the cars and the time and the resources to make a choice to spend today together. It's very, very special. We're all very fortunate. Okay. I have somebody raising their hand. Yes.